Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here at these clone vats, and I don't see clones at the moment. Here's one. What'd it say? Clutching each other? Somewhere around? I guess you guys can go back and read that. These things keep disappearing. The process that was growing these life forms have been halted. I guess you guys can read this faster than I can. Either intentionally or due to a loss of power, leaving many of them in a hideous half-formed state. Wouldn't this someone said there was something like clutching themselves or something? I don't want to see that. Well, these things would love to eat us, so we cannot cross. Not what I want to, but we have to get to the other side. So I know what to do. It's not completely sure I can accomplish it with everything on hand. I'm probably going to need something from somewhere else, but you never know. We're going to electrify all this stuff and kill everything within. And I hope it succeeds before we set foot into this. This is all flesh, apparently. Yeah, this one won't come back. Alright, so this generator. Generator rig hums softly. So it's already on.
Still has fuel in it. Some luck at last.
I'm gonna get electrocuted.
I thought that was too easy.
Okay, so we got the generator, we got the pole. We got this, about this crowbar. That do anything? Alright, so how are we gonna knock this down? Can I drill into it? Maybe. Well, there we go. Still no. Maybe now use the crowbar. That tape might serve some function as well.
Okay, now let's see what I can do.
See what we can do indeed. Expose wires. Darkness. Attack the darkness. There's John and there's exposed wires. Generator's off. They're still humming softly. Where's the exposed wire? Is this gonna kill me? Yeah, wish the door had been locked. Alright, so you'd think I could reach this, right? But what's it say? The light is off now. Hold on, guys. I'm trying to figure out how to destroy you. Just stand by. Maybe if I put the tape here? No. Not sure what I'm thinking right now. What do I attach to these exposed wires? I don't think any of these things are any good for it. I'm just seeing what sticks.
I
I know I don't want to touch the exposed wires, so I'm not sure what else to do with them.
I think that will just break it.
Break what? What are we breaking?
I don't think that'll work.
We're missing something in the... See, what about this wire? See, what I wanted to do is take this wire... Can't zoom in, it's unfortunate. Take this wire, or whatever, detach from the construction light, right? Because that's what it's hooked up to now. But I can only look at the construction light.
Hmm. Maybe. No.
No.
I think that'll just break it. No. Crazy.
I know. I am.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Can I... I can't go further down here. It's unfortunate. I can't even walk past this light here. Good thing these things apparently can't get out of the vat. So this must have been where these sounds are coming from. Unimaginable purposes. The depths of the chamber are unlit. It's difficult to estimate how far down the tanks go. Each darkness has a different description. I'm really just putting off the inevitable that I don't know what to do. Back in here, maybe? Can I change anything here? Well, I want to attach the... We need a way into that toolkit, don't we? To do something with the exposed wires. The thing that kills me is he might have... he might have the key. Would we use the tape to try to drag the key? That's a long shot. So just stand here, but don't go in there. In real life, this would not work. No.
Maybe. No. No, that won't work. I think that'll just break it.
If I step off of here, I'm gonna get attacked by something. And killed. There's something I'm missing here. Now, naturally, I have tried everything... Every way to get into this thing. I've tried with the crowbar. tried the drill.
Maybe. No. I think that'll just break it.
I don't know what to tape on what I'm thinking of there. This is PDA, which we read last episode. Empty metal boxes, which are empty. What's this? Nothing? I mean, maybe if I sift through debris, I can find something that would act as a key? Pick a lock? No, I went in. That's not what I was clicking on. I can't believe I'm stuck already. There's not a lot of items. Hopefully I didn't miss something. Nice kitty. Good kitty. Maybe a crowbar and smash some debris?
Maybe.
No. I'm missing something in the equation here. Oh, and he won't run. I noticed that. He will run here. So how do I attach the generator to this? Maybe that's not what we want to be doing? I don't know what else to do. It's attached to the construction light right now. I can turn it on, and it will run briefly. The light will turn on. Bunch of babies, man. Ugh. I really don't know what to do. You should be able to click on this and detach this. I can't even get a good view of what we're looking at here. Generator. Construction light.
No. Crazy.
Morning something or other. I don't know.
Nah, that's ridiculous.
Alright, stand by, guys, because I'm getting nothing done in here, and this can't be enjoyable for you to watch, so I'll be back when I figure anything out. Okay, I accomplished something. I was able to combine these items. Crowbar and the tape.
This should be useful.
Crowbar grappling hook. That was very rude. So maybe use it on the dead body. What if... Oh, just disappeared. I want to grab him, actually. But
maybe if it... No, that won't work.
I want to hear him, like, really adversely say something. So I'm assuming get the keys on him and do it this way. Must be some strong tape.
Rest in peace.
Toolbox keys. Now this is an odd thing. Is he gonna step in there? Oh.
Wow.
Okay. It's funny how they kinda look like statues. I know they aren't. So we will advance here, eventually. And then we can come to this giant brain here, and then some stuff there, and a fallen springity-springity thingy. There's a computer terminal here. More vats beyond. How do I get out of this? Okay. Okay, so hopefully we'll find something we can work with here. I'll have to remember to keep, trying to combine items. John toolbox. Okay, I guess we're gonna look in the toolbox. We'll just randomly grab something out of there. What is that? I hate that. I went too far to the edge of the screen again. Jumper cable. Okay, to attach to the generator. Awesome. I guess nothing else in here. Alright. Okay, attach jumper cable. Still have the crowbar grappling hook, too.
This goes on here.
Okay.
And this goes over here.
Mm-hmm. Let's fry us up some clones. Well, you weren't concerned about them at all. My neural activity. I just killed these beings. Not like I actually probably put them out of their misery. I kind of feel like this is a good time to save just in case something is still alive in there. Kind of curious, actually. Those are still alive. Hopefully those won't attack me. Can I just run across up to here? Good God.
Yes. Just stay above the water.
Oh I'm looking for something coming after me. Ooh. That's nasty. Well, we made it across. So proud.
Tia, can you hear me? I'm working on getting out of here. I can see a light far above me. I think it's a way out.
Guess she can't hear us. Broken computer terminal. Spider webs of cracks radiate outwards from several damaged sections of this display panel. No power runs through the terminal. It's busted. The screen of the terminal is smashed and splashed with speckles of blood. I know they're broken. Just want to see if it was saying that react to them. Broken ladder. Rests on its side like a wounded beast.
Perfect.
I didn't pick something up. I guess we can use that for something. VAT 12 computer terminal. I feel like I'm playing Fallout now, right? Is this the mixture? The what do you call it? Dip the become a mutant, super mutant. VAT 13 and VAT 11. All right, let's try this one. Partially grown flesh. Below the observation platform, a sea of artificially grown flesh sits slowly rotting, the progress of decay only partially stalled by the chill running through the room. Good God. Same here. A large power generator is half submerged in the foul-smelling organic soup. They hopefully won't have to electrocute any more engineered human things. Alright, let's see if they can get anything from the VAT 12 computer terminal. Hello, my name is unknown. That's a ultrasound reading. VAT Epsilon 449, standard growth enhancement agents, 150% concentration, plus additional growth hormones obtained from Project Seed, incomplete human clones intended for harvest of pulmonary and coronary tissue. Oh, really? Okay, so that's what the lungs and heart he was talking about, right? It was lungs. For sure it was lungs and heart. Report 449A. Products developing at 800% acceleration from the selected control group. However, several anomalies have occurred. Anomaly example, a tissue mass has developed into a tail of sorts. It circles the VAT, using the aforementioned tail to propel itself. Yeah, we read about that in Olson's, the engineer Olson's, Albert Olson's PDA. 449B. Mass with tail appendage has been assigned a name, Samantha. Despite the previous belief that the circling behavior was a product of instinct, it is now clear that it has been surveying the VAT's electronic safety net and searching for vulnerabilities. Oh, brother. It's intelligent. I don't like that. And report 449C. Samantha has been extracted and moved to security for temporary storage. She thrashed violently upon removal, damaging equipment and other specimens. Huh. I wonder if Samantha is the main culprit of what's been going on here at the station. What we saw running kind of ran in front of us for a second when we walked outward past, what's his name? Yuri? Into the room past the corpse of Yuri? Alright, Samantha, I've been hearing stuff about you. Crossbeam. A crossbeam runs between the support columns. VAT 13 computer terminal, partially grown organic matter. In a dim light, your eyes can make out more discernible shapes in the meaty clumps below. The arc of an arm, a head's partial dome, and the spinal curve of a body in the fetal position. That is pretty dreadful stuff. Mobile construction lift. This lift platform seems designed to move workers around above the VATs, possibly for maintenance or construction work. Well, it's seen better days, I'm sure. Vat Kappa, 583 Kappa. Growth agent enriched with additional amino acids, 300% concentration. Enhanced human clones intended for immediate research. Report 583A. Specimens begin to move around the vat immediately during the embryonic phase. 583B. All subjects developing at nearly 500% acceleration. Effect of growth agent concentration on subject development ruled parabolic rather than linear. Okay. Growing all at once rather than one at a time? Is that what that means? 583C. Multiple subjects have combined to form a larger mass of anthropoid limbs and organs. It surfaced and was then ruled deceased. It appeared to be composed of approximately 12 human-like bodies, all roughly infant-sized. Oh, good God. Batch has been active for 96 hours. Development of other subjects remains regular. Wow. Okay. What we got over here? Anything we can look at? Darkness stuff. The metal stamp on this terminal indicates that it controls Vat 11. In front of it sits a throne-like operator's chair. I didn't read this one. A plastic tiki doll stands at the back of the keyboard, its skirt swaying back and forth in a silent luau. Throne-like operator's chair. I can't see anything with this vat. It goes off screen, so... Vat Theta, 152. Standard growth enhancement agents. Complete human clones, intended for immediate testing. Report 152A. Subjects appear to develop bone and tendon structure prior to vital organs, but following nervous system development. B. Growth of muscle has begun to progress. One specimen ceased to grow and was confirmed dead. Upon autopsy, 3 extra vertebrae were discovered, as well as 2 ribs. However, only a few teeth were found deep within the mandible. I was going to say, if they didn't fix my ribs, I had 4 broken ribs. Could, like, snag some of those ribs. What's it say? Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was black as coal. When Mary went to bed one night, I ate her bleeping soul. Who wrote that? Don't tell me Samantha is that intelligent. That's pretty disturbing. C. Growth of all specimens has accelerated. Any given clone measures just under 7 foot and possesses the auxiliary ribs and vertebrae observed in the failed subject. And 152D. All vital organs are present and appear to be performing normally. Despite the abnormal rib and spinal developments, the clones seem to be perfectly functional and fully matured. One, however, was rendered blind as a result of improper sphenoid development. Sphenoid development, huh? I don't know this word, sphenoid. Alright, so... Where do I go now? Am I supposed to make my way through these vats now? There's nothing living in them. Where's my, oh. Yeah, he won't get in. Don't blame him. He wants to do something with his broken ladder. Maybe we want to go up? Should I be using the crowbar grappling hook with the broken ladder?
I don't think that'll work.
Oh. Wait.
I don't think this'll fit.
Won't fit? Not a syringe.
I think that'll just break it.
Yeah. Probably will, depending on what you're doing with it. Maybe we don't want to use the ladder, just the idea of a ladder. Well, you're jumping right there. It's not gonna work. Alright, well, use our grappling hook then.
Got it!
Alright. Why is everything shaking? Am I really that heavy? I lost the grappling hook, damn it. Where? Oh,
I hate this damn place.
I do not blame you. Where am I? Somewhere along. I'm John, I'm up here now. Okay, here I thought we were going to explore each vat, but apparently not. You know we're vulnerable going up this ladder. Something's probably going to happen any moment, right? What was that beeping sound? Yep.
Tia. I can't off, but I can hear you.
Crap. Is that her? A maintenance hatch for engineer access is set in the platform. Well, I guess we're not opening that. Boarded up tram. The boarded up entrances indicate that the trams have been out of service for some time. You board them up just to keep people from going on them? Wouldn't they be aware that not to go in there? Temporarily out of service. Wouldn't the sign be sufficient? Graffiti. Rarely trafficked areas breed unconventional forms of life. Here, the graffiti tagger has covered the tram station with a wild variety of tribal markings. Hmm. Oh, it's not just on the sign. Overhead tram rail. The magnetic stoppers on the tram's guide rails look sturdier than many other parts of this aging vessel. Tram line in shadow. The trams grip the tracks greedily with their many legs. Oh yeah, I see that. So we're back to just our standard drill and syringe items. Don't even have the crowbar. Yeah, because we made it. Ah. That's a heavy loss, man. We need a crowbar.
Maybe if it. No. No, that won't work.
I guess we're not going to be using that tram then. So if I go here, we can go. Going off. There looked to be something like. Oh.
There's some sort of interference with the structure.
I'm in a tram station.
That'll do it. Who's that? I saw that. Is that his wife? Don't go back, no. Can he run off?
Oxygen, nitrogen storage require further maintenance to solve isolation.
Preservation of what? So I guess I'm not using this tram either. Oh! I saw that. It ran that way. Okay. Not very happy right now. It It ran this way. Let me go this way.
The tower.
Thank you.
I am pressurizing the raw materials containment tank.
Come in.
Pressurizing the tank.
Oh goodness, I can hear you. He just disappeared. No radio, no PDT.
Who the hell was that?
Dr. Aldous Milan, head of special projects.
Who knew you?
It's a big ship. And I'm in a different division to him entirely. I only met him once. A real arsehole.
Just want to get out of this goddamn place.
That's the plan.
That should have knocked me over. Yeah, he's not just an ass, he's incredibly psychotic.